didn't you let me know you were aboard?
Well, I didn't get my orders until the last minute.
Well, I'm glad to see you. How's your father?
Very well, sir.
Good. You'll sit at my table, of course.
Well, that's what I came to see you about, sir. Do you mind if I don't sit at your table and let you forget you know me? You see, I'm on my way to teach the colonial troops a few new tricks. The next 2 years promised nothing but sun, sand, and hard work, so I thought I might have one last little fling before we land.
Why, of course, my boy. And good luck.
Thank you, sir. What is this, an octopus?
No, just my scarf.
Well.
I'm sorry. The wind carried it away.
Three cheers for the wind. Oh, forgive me. I'm Paul Dumont, at your service.
Thank you.
Oh, Stuart.
Oui, monsieur.
Did you just pass a lady carrying a light blue scarf?
Light blue scarf? Oh, yes, Mademoiselle Laroche.
Laroche. Does she have a deck chair?
It's against the rules to give out information concerning... Yes, a deck chair. Of course.
What's the number?
Number? Oh, I have the list. Mademoiselle Helene Laroche, number 7.
Number 7. Do I have a deck chair?
Oh, yes, of course. Let me see.
What's the number?
Here you are. Number 6.
6. Good.
Monsieur, just in case, of course, no one will ask, but what is the name?
Paul Dumont. Thank you.
Thank you, monsieur.
Stuart.
Oui, mademoiselle.
You were talking to a gentleman just now.
Oh, yes, Monsieur Paul Dumont.
Was he, by any chance, engaging a deck chair?
It is against the rules to give out information concerning... Oh, yes, of course. Monsieur Paul Dumont, he is engaged deck chair number 6.
That's what I was afraid of. I'm sure I'm not going to like number 7.
It might be arranged to move, mademoiselle.
Then arrange it, by all means.
Yes, mademoiselle. Thank you.
Thank you, Stuart.
I beg your pardon, madame, but I believe you have my chair.
Your chair? Why, it's number 6, isn't it? Why, look.
Well, there seems to be some mistake, madame. You see, I couldn't get along without this chair. It's an old family heirloom, and I...
Stuart, this man is claiming that this is his chair.
Yeah, see here, you told me my chair was number 6.
The gentleman is mistaken. I said number 16.
But I distinctly heard you say...
Monsieur, 16.
Now you get out of here or I'll call the captain.
Mademoiselle, I faced this voyage with trepidation. I said to myself, I shall feel miserable. I decided to keep to my stateroom, but something drew me irresistibly to the deck. And then your scarf blew into my face, and I met you. But you were cruel, mademoiselle. Haven't you any pity for me? Can't you give me one little word?
Steward!
Oui, mademoiselle.
Please show this gentleman to his own chair.
This is his chair, number 16.
But you told me that...
Mademoiselle.
The best laid plans. You know, that fellow after this voyage is going to be able to retire and buy himself a farm.
And I thought I was so clever.
And I, mademoiselle. You should have seen Mrs. Davenport in chair number 6 when I tried to claim it. Good old Mrs. Davenport. She was so firm. Baedeker's Guide to Algeria. Remind me to tell you about Algeria. The desert, the moonlight.
You have been to Algeria, monsieur?
No, but I've been out in the moonlight. They have the same old moon over there, don't they?
Oh, indeed. Only more so. Have you been to Algeria, mademoiselle?
No, my first trip.
You'll find it interesting. I was born there and lived there until they sent me to Paris to be civilized.
Oh, how did you like my country?
Very much. I found it most charming and amusing. Now I must go back to give my tribesmen the benefit of the culture I am supposed to have absorbed.
I should think you'd be lonely after Paris.
Loneliness is comparative. Sometimes one is desperately lonely in a crowd.
Yeah. But then sometimes even one more person is too many.
Abdullah Mafadi. Abdullah Mafadi.
Yes, Stuart.
Wireless, sir.
Thank you. Someone must have hurt you. Excuse me, please.
I hope I wasn't too rude.
No, I don't think so. He seemed rather amused. It was very nice.
Yes, but I'm glad he's gone. You know, I can't stand too much competition so soon.
Oh, I see. After you've had a chance to make your indelible impression, competition doesn't matter.
I invite it. The women I have really known laugh at the clumsy efforts of other men. Their one reply to every impassioned avowal is, I have known Paul Dumont.
Well, your confidence is at least refreshing. How long do you need for this impression?
That depends on the subject. Under pressure, I think I could do a rather workmanlike job by the time we reach Port Ekbar. Shall we discuss it over a cocktail?
You're practically daring me.
What'll it be?
Martini.
Bourbon with plain water.
Only the beginning. Years of perfection, hours of ecstasy beckon to us.
Except that we dock tomorrow morning and then...
There is no tomorrow. Only tonight and us. Who is it?
It is the steward.
Well, stop that noise and come in.
Monsieur?
Yeah, huh?
It is 10 o'clock.
All right, so it's 10 o'clock. Go away, will you? Leave me.
10 o'clock? Did you say 10 o'clock?
Yes, monsieur.
Well, don't stand there. Do something. I was supposed to meet Mademoiselle Laroche at 9. Call her stateroom. Tell her I'm late.
It wouldn't do any good. Mademoiselle left the boat at 9.
What?
We docked at 8:30, and Mademoiselle left immediately.
Well, where did she go? Why wasn't I notified? What do you mean, letting me sleep through this? Go find her. Send her some flowers. Send her some telegrams. Come in.
Lieutenant Dumont?
Yes?
Williams of the Senegalese reporting, sir.
Oh, at ease, Sergeant. Here, go do what I told you. Here's some money.
Merci, monsieur. Merci.
All right, run along. And you, Sergeant, get your men together. Start loading our equipment. I'll be down as soon as I get dressed.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Monsieur Dumont, isn't it? Or rather, Lieutenant Dumont.
Yes, back to business.
Oh, I should have known you were an army officer from the way you walk.
I'm glad you didn't. I was on the loose, sir. Oh, by the way, I didn't mean to be rude.
Oh, you mean a remark about the crowd? Oh, forget it. As a matter of fact, I was looking for a reason to leave. Do you expect to stay in this country long?
2 years. I'm on my way to Fort Harun.
Oh, splendid. That's in my territory. Well, I hope we see some of each other.
I hope we do. Oh, Stuart.
Yes, monsieur.
Can we meet again?
Good day, sir.
Good day. What'd you find out?
Nothing, monsieur. Not a trace of Mademoiselle Laroche.
Where can she be? Where could she have gone?
I can't say, monsieur. I tried my best. Now you excuse me. I must go back to work.
Oh, Stuart.
Oui, monsieur.
You didn't send any flowers?
No, monsieur.
You didn't send any telegrams?
No, monsieur.
In fact, it cost you practically nothing.
Quite right, monsieur.
Well, keep the change.
Oh, thank you, monsieur.
Come on, meatball. Come on, bat down on that trunk. Hey, Satchel, get Bobo a hand on that box. Y'all got to wear that stuff when you get it unpacked.
Where did you find those names, Satchel, Bobo, Meatball?
Well, I gave it to them, sir. You see, them Senegalese names are so long drawn out, so nastily, I just named them for myself.
Well, your name, Williams, that isn't Senegalese either, is it?
No, sir.
Well, what's your first name?
Blue.
Blue, you mean blue like a color?
No, sir, I mean blue like da 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 da.
Where'd you pick that up, Connie's or the Cotton Club?
Does the lieutenant know about Harlem?
Sure, I was stationed at the New York consulate for 2 years. I used to run up to Harlem all the time. How long have you been away?
Oh, about 6 years. You see, I was running a little number game over there till things got a little hot for me. In fact, it got so hot till I picked 4 bullets out of my bon voyage cake.
Right on your tail, huh?
I guess that's what that weight was, but I was too scared to look back.
How'd you find your way out here?
I was looking for peace, but they found out I can handle a machine gun, so they made me a sergeant.
Oh, well, you get your boys all shined up. Meet me at the airport at 4 o'clock.
Yes, sir.
Because you men are the best marksmen in the Senegalese regiments, you've been chosen for this detail to be trained as parachute troops. This assignment is quite an honor, since you will travel to every post in the colonies to give demonstrations. We'll leave by plane in a few minutes for Fort Harun. Remember that the rest of the Colonial Army will be watching you. So conduct yourselves at all times in a manner becoming. Sergeant, take charge of the detail.
Yes, sir.
Everything ready, Sergeant?
All set, sir.
Attention! About face. File into that plane and take seats in order. Fall out.
Choose Senegalese for this detail, Lieutenant?
Well, I think they reasoned that if the troops saw the Senegalese parachuting, they'd all be eager to try it. They'd have no trouble filling the regiment.
Wonder how they're making out back there. It's the first time in the air for some of them.
I don't know. I thought I'd treat it as an everyday occurrence and let them figure things out for themselves.
What the lieutenant told y'all goes double for me. If I catch any of y'all stepping out of line, I'll wrap one of these rifles around your neck.
Sergeant, I don't figure on stepping out of line. But what I want to know is, who is we?
Yeah, me too.
Well, I'll explain that. We is parachute riflemen.
Well, I understand shooting, but what's this parachute?
That's what each and every one of you is sitting on. Them things with the straps wrapped around your legs.
Say, how do we operate?
How do we operate? Supposing that we are sitting into the barracks quietly, and trouble starts about 100 miles away, what do we do? You, Satchel, you tell me.
We starts walking. When we gets there, we's too late.
Now, that's why you're wrong. That's old-time army style. We're streamlined. You know what we do? We pile into the plane. We make this 100 miles in a jiffy. Then we jump out right into the middle of the trouble.
Wait a minute, Sergeant. What's that about this jumping out?
We're streamlined. We ain't got time to wait till the plane stop. We just jump out.
While the plane's in the air?
Yes, sir. Right that little door.
From this high?
From twice this high.
When we lands, we's in no condition for fighting, is we?
Of course we is. That's where the parachuting comes in. You see this handle? Well, you hold it. Then you run to the door and jump. Count 10, and then you pull the handle. And then you start to float into the air just like a bird.
I saw a man do that once, so that's what you call parachuting.
Good old parachute. Ain't that something?
Yeah.
Just floating like a bird.
Here we come, right in the middle of that old trouble. Just a floating down.
Now, Satchel, what's the matter with you?
I can't count to 10.
How high can you count to 8?
Well, it does real good up to 6.
Well, now that's good. Count 6 twice. And when you get to 4 the second time, that's 10.
Sergeant, there's one thing more.
What's that?
Suppose he grabs the handle, jumps out the door, counts to 10, pulls the handle, and the parachute don't open. What then?
Then you report to the lieutenant. He can fix anything.
Did you arrange quarters for the Senegalese, Captain?
Yes, sir.
Parachute troops. What's the region coming to?
Paul Dumont's a good man, sir. The very best.
Yes, I know.
he is. Bring him by for dinner tonight.
Yes, sir.
Come on, George.
Nice trip.
Splendid. You're looking well.
I am well. Never better.
Details correct, sir.
Fine.
Oh, Sergeant Bartosz will take care of your men, Paul.
Thanks. Follow Sergeant Bartosz. Get your equipment put away. He'll show you your quarters. Then check with me later.
Yes, sir.
Come on, I'll show you where you live, but you have to make a quick change. The colonel's expecting us for dinner.
Fine.
Good evening, sir. May I present Lieutenant Dumont, Paul, Colonel Fouché.
Colonel?
How are you, Lieutenant? Good trip. Men all taken care of. That's fine. We start to work tomorrow morning. Make yourself at home. Excuse me.
Now, what's that big surprise you had in store for me?
You'll find out in just a minute.
Que vous êtes charmante toutes les deux.
Oh, merci.
I was just telling Helene how happy she will be here.
Oh, that...
My dear... May I present Lieutenant Dumont, Lieutenant Madame Fouché.
How do you do, Lieutenant?
Madame Fouché.
And may I present you, Mademoiselle Helene Laroche. Helene, Lieutenant Dumont.
Helene, why didn't you tell me you were coming out here? Why did you run out so early?
They had a plane there to meet me.
Well, don't tell me you know each other.
Of course, we came over in the same boat.
Then everyone knows the great good fortune which comes to the regiment. And this little dinner tonight is by way of announcing the marriage on next Tuesday of Mademoiselle Helene Laroche and Captain Jean Brideau.
Dinner is served.
Oh, come on, let's go in. I'm famished. And you two gentlemen squabble over Helene.
Right.
Helene, you're not marrying Jean. It isn't true.
But it is. That's why I came to Algeria.
But you can't do this to me. Here, I've just found you and you're engaged to my best friend. What about my indelible impression?
Please, Lieutenant. There's no need to keep up your pretense. You were very amusing on the boat.
Amusing? Yes, I must have been. That night at the rail, especially.
That night at the rail, we were both a little foolish. But as I remember, it was you who said, there is no tomorrow. Can't we leave it like that?
As you wish, mademoiselle.
Helene? Helene?
Yes, Jean?
Well, here you are, darling. And Paul, that's fine. I want you two to be the best of friends, eh, Paul?
Yes, of course, Jean.
Shall we go inside? I'm afraid I'm not quite used to these Algerian nights.
This is your first test. I've taught you everything about a parachute that you can learn except by actually using one. Remember that Captain Bordeaux and a Legion detachment will be on the ground watching you. I'll go first, Sergeant Williams next, and the rest follow in regular order. Any questions?
No, sir.
All right, here we go.
Forget to count 10. And when you land, assemble on Sergeant Williams. All right?
Yes, sir.
six, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10.
Still say that there is a place for the birds.
Good work.
Thanks.
My brother Abdullah has brought back talk of peace. He believes everything the infidels have told him. Does that look like peace?
Take it easy, y'all, now. Don't get excited now. Take it easy. By the number now. Come on now. Let's go. Come on now. Take it easy. Come on, y'all.
Right up in there. Get behind him. Come on. Right up to 500-yard range. Come on, now. Come on. Huh. Captain Brideau. Remember him, Hassan?
Very well.
He commanded the legion at the oasis of Ibrahim. A score of our people were slaughtered.
We promised to repay that little debt, didn't we, Hassan?
Ah, it's quite a demonstration.
Cease firing!
Once more?
No, I think that's enough for today. We'll camp here tonight and leave for Fort Harun in the morning.
All right, Corporal. We'll go back to camp.
Now, that's what I call parachuting.
Yes, sir, ain't it just?
Was I happy when that parachute popped open?
Yeah.
What's the matter, Sergeant?
Bobo!
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 Where's Bobo?
Here he is! Come get me.
Come on, let's get that boy from down up there.
I imagine this parachute business is a surprise to the old-timers. But in face of what's happening on the continent, I think a lot of us are going to have to readjust our ideas of tactics. You know, it's a funny thing. The general staff always figures the next war is going to be fought exactly like the last one. But it never is.
Yeah, I suppose so. But at the present time, my main interest is getting back to Harun. Not that I haven't enjoyed this detail with you, Paul, but...
I understand, Jean. If I were in your place, I wouldn't be thinking much about parachute troops or training tactics. You're a very lucky man, Jean.
She is lovely, isn't she? We grew up together in Normandy. Until she arrived a couple days ago, I hadn't seen her since my last leave. 3 years ago. And all that time, I don't believe there's a single moment when I wasn't thinking about it. And I believe she's thinking about me, too.
I'm sure she was.
Yeah, it was great about your meeting on the boat, wasn't it?
Yes, of course, I didn't see much of her. Facing 2 years out here, I wasn't looking for the sort of company that Helene promised to be.
Oh, you're on the loose, huh?
Yes. But this time, there was a surprising lack of satisfaction in it.
You're growing up, Paul. Still, after the wedding, we'll have to concentrate on finding a girl like Helene for you.
Yes, of course. Well, there's plenty of time for that.
Think a fella could have a smoke?
Yeah, if you don't care where you spend the next 5 years.
Legion, outside! Outside!
Into the rock, sir.
They sure come and go fast.
Is the captain hit bad?
I'm afraid so. Help me get him into the tent.
I saw the lieutenant, but I was uh-oh.
Halt!
We are forced to delay your departure. There he is, Captain.
That's the fellow that was in the tent.
Yes, sir.
We'll make an example of him when we get him back to Fort Haroon. How do you feel, John?
Oh, it could be worse.
Sergeant, I'll fly Captain Bordeaux and the wounded in. You take charge of the detachment and start for the fort immediately. I'll send an escort to you as soon as I arrive.
Yes, sir.
Come in.
Sorry to trouble you, Lieutenant.
That's all right. What is it, Sergeant?
Have we an extra parachute around here?
I don't know. What do you want with the next one?
Well, you see, Satchel, he just died.
Satchel? You mean the big number one?
Yes, he was cut up awful bad in the fracas the other night when he was on guard.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir. About that parachute, sir. He asked us just before he died if we would strap one on him before we put him away. Of course, I know it would be awful uncomfortable for him, but he was mighty proud of that parachute, sir.
I understand, Sergeant. Here, take mine. We'll arrange a military funeral. I suppose the detachment would like to be the escort?
Yes, sir.
All right, I'll take care of the details.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Thank you.
Good night, Sergeant. Cute little bullet, huh?
Yes, I asked the doctor for it.
Another bead for my Legion necklace.
Well, at least they didn't file the steel jacket on it.
This probably would save my life, that and the fact that you were there.
Ah, forget it. Well, I've got to finish my report about the attack. You get some rest, and I'll see you later, huh?
All right, Paul, you run along.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Morning.
Paul, I called your quarters several times. I hope you haven't been avoiding me.
Quite to the contrary, mademoiselle.
Please, I wanted to thank you for saving Jean's life.
Oh, I'm afraid that's been dramatized a bit. You see, I also saved my own life, which is more to the point.
I doubt it.
Let's not get a storybook perspective on this thing. If the positions have been reversed, Jean would have done exactly as I did.
And you would have felt exactly as he does.
Commanding officer's compliments, sir. Will the lieutenant report to headquarters at once?
Thank you, Sergeant. Duty seems to be calling us both. Excuse me, mademoiselle.
Oh, come in, Paul. Sheikh Abdullah tells me that you two met on the boat.
Yes, how are you?
Very well, lieutenant. You see, we do meet again.
Yes.
And you, Abdullah, in Saumur.
9 years ago, wasn't it?
Yes. He was one of our finest horsemen. Did you keep up your riding?
After a fashion.
I'm afraid I'm a bit rusty.
One gets that way out here.
All ready, sir.
Good. See that Sheikh Abdullah is permitted to spend as much time as he desires with the prisoner.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Colonel. See you later, Lieutenant.
Delicate matter, Paul. That prisoner you brought from Wadi Bendu is his younger brother.
Abdullah.
You young fool.
I'm sorry, my brother. It was stupid.
Stupid is no word for it. I tried to bring peace to the desert, and you spoil everything by attacking a training detachment.
I? Attack a training detachment?
Yes, of course. Why else would you be prisoner?
But I had no part in the attack. You expressly forbade that.
Did you tell it to the Legion?
They are only too anxious to execute one of our people. Who would believe me?
But they will believe me. For the detachment in the afternoon, and was fascinated by the parachute troop. He followed back to camp. When the attack started, he became afraid, tried to run away, and was captured.
How about that, Lieutenant? You identified him as the man who was in the tent.
Positively. It was night. The lieutenant might have been mistaken.
Hardly. He was bending over Captain Bordeaux when I awakened. I grabbed him when we fought together. I'd know the man anyplace.
Did Jean see him?
I'm not sure.
Then you overpowered him and took his knife away.
Well, not exactly. I got in a lucky punch and he fell backward into the brush. My men scattered the tribesmen and the prisoner was captured.
We'll look into that. If he had no part in the attack, he'll be released. We are all agreed that the prisoner was present at the attack. But there seemed to be some question as to his participation. We thought you might be able to help us.
I believe I can, sir. I saw the tribesman who was fighting Lieutenant Dumont.
Good. Sergeant Bartosz.
Yes, sir.
Bring in the prisoner. Captain Bridau, I now ask you if you recognize this man.
Yes, sir. He is the tribesman who fought Lieutenant Dumont in the attack at Wadi Bendu.
It was night. The captain was wounded.
Could these facts have affected your identification, Captain?
No, sir. I could see plainly inside the tent. I wasn't wounded until after we rushed outside.
Does the prisoner wish to make a statement?
No. My brother has nothing more to say.
Return the prisoner.
Yes, sir.
Thanks, Captain.
But surely, Colonel, the execution of my brother is no indication of the friendship your government professes for my people.
You overlook entirely the fact that legionnaires were killed.
So were tribesmen. Doesn't that satisfy your national honor?
National honor has nothing to do with trading lives. This was a training detachment unwarrantedly attacked.
My brother had nothing to do with it.
He not only participated in the attack, but led it, according to the testimony of two officers in my regiment. Either one of them might be mistaken. Certainly not both.
Unless they had agreed on the story beforehand.
You are implying that officers of the Legion would perjure themselves over the life of a prisoner?
No more than you imply that my brother is lying.
I am sorry. In the face of the evidence,
I have no alternative. See that this is carried out immediately.
Yes, sir. Action. Halt. Lift. Face. Prisoner forward. That means you.
Nonsense. I want to feel that I'm helping.
Oh, but darling, you're helping just by being here. Come.
Oh, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Come in, Paul. You're not interrupting. Where have you been keeping yourself?
Busy with the Sunny Police. Hello, Helene.
Hello, Paul.
No more attacks?
No, that Ben Alley business was a lesson to the natives, I suppose. Everything's peace and quiet. When are you coming out of this?
Well, I hobbled around the room today. The doctor said I should be up in about a week.
Good. We miss you.
Oh, I know you have lots of things to do, but, well, I'm afraid Helene isn't enjoying herself.
Please, Jean.
I'm afraid she's getting the wrong impression of Haroon, what with having seen nothing but the colonel's quarters and the hospital. I've been telling her about the bazaar. Why don't you take her down and show her the native quarter and the bakers? I mean, take her to that little cafe and let her see the dances.
Waiter.
Gustav.
Oh, an old friend. Now, this is the main street of the native quarters. These dark-complexioned gentlemen are vendors. Don't pay any attention to them. They'll sell you a lot of apples and turnips and beets. And
I like beets the second day, anyway. They're much better when they're cold.
Oh, I know what you mean. Like apple pie with milk.
Ooh.
Well, don't pay any attention to that. That's just a cobra, you know, one of those... Now, probably made in Paterson, New Jersey. You know New Jersey, don't you?
Oh, yeah, in America.
Yeah, right across the river from Portsmouth.
It's Arabian fruit.
No, thanks.
What's this?
That's a sand diviner. Some of them are pretty good.
That one was his fortune? A sunken ready future in the sands.
Let's hear what he has to say.
All right.
Please, inside. This way, please. Mademoiselle here and the lieutenant here. Hassan will prepare the sands. You have come a long way, mademoiselle.
That's fairly obvious.
Hassan can only read the sands.
Of course. Go on.
You are facing an altogether new life. Many unexpected things are ordered for you. Love, danger, weird plottings, and all the time, death hovers near. Death for someone close to you.
Can't you tell her anything more pleasant?
Hassan can only read the sands. Oh, yes, there is love. Much love.
Tell me about that.
There is love like the flow of the river. Steady, constant. But in the background, there is another love. A burning, devastating, all-consuming love.
That's the same love, developing, growing.
No, mademoiselle, it is not the same. It is a younger, more vital love.
Why do you say that?
To use your own words, lieutenant, That is fairly obvious.
Yeah. Your anger proves it.
Baker, come on, let's get out of here.
There are none so blind.
Please, Paul. You've been practically running ever since we left that sand of honor. Are you in such a hurry to get rid of me?
Helene, this situation can't go on. When even a native sand diviner can see the truth, I must be making another fool of myself. Started out as fun on the boat, but how did I know it was going to backfire like this?
How did either of us know it, Paul? We thought it was going to be all over in the morning, that we would never see each other again.
Instead, you turn up at Fort Harun and gaze to Jean. Why couldn't you have... that isn't fair. Why didn't I tell you where I was going?
Well, that's what made it all so intriguing. Neither of us asked a question of the other. We took what those few hours had to offer. Well, as you say, it backfired. I suppose it was my fault. I was on my way to marry Jean. But I've been on my way to marry Jean ever since I can remember. My father always objected. A few years ago, he died, and since then, there was no reason to postpone it longer. Then I met you on the boat. And suddenly, there was a very good reason.
What are we going to do?
You've known him a long time, haven't you?
10 years. Mostly in the Legion. We came out from France together. I was just out of military school. He was a vastly superior first lieutenant with 4 years' service. He showed me the ropes. I couldn't have gotten along without him.
Yes. There's something so dependable about you.
We can't hurt him. We mustn't.
Then we mustn't make a mess of three lives. Go to him, Paul. Tell him what has happened to us. He must understand.
Hello, Paul.
I'll be back right away, Captain.
All right. I've been out in the veranda. Don't you think I'm doing well?
Fine. Here, have a chair.
Oh, no. No, in a couple more days, and I'll be as good as new. Tell me, what do you think of Monday for the wedding?
Well, Jean, that's what I want to talk to you about.
There's nothing to talk about. We're going to have a military wedding with all the trimmings, and you're going to be best man.
Yes, but you see,
But there are no buts. I'm a man altar-bound, and I'll brook no interference. You wouldn't run out on me, would you? You wouldn't let me down at the last moment, would you?
No, Jean. I wouldn't run out on you.
That's good.
And so, I request the commanding officer's cooperation in securing an immediate transfer. I can't understand it, Paul. Only a few days ago, you outlined the most ambitious plan for instructing the entire command in parachuting. And now you ask me to certify that your work at this post is completed.
I was mistaken in this possibility, sir. The Legion is too steeped in tradition to take kindly to such a radical departure from routine.
I'm sorry to hear you say that. Abdullah apparently is planning reprisals for the execution of his brother. Intelligence reports activities among the tribes. Quantities of material are arriving at the coast, and strange enough, disappearing.
The Colonel knows the Legion is fully capable of taking care of Abdullah in its own peculiar manner.
Very well. I'll follow you up to your request.
Thank you, sir.
Sit down, child. I want to talk to you. Please. Don't think that I'm an interfering old busybody. The commanding officer's wife is really the dictator of the regiment's social activities. Morals, charities, in fact, everything. So you see, I'm entitled to quite a little latitude.
Yes, of course, Madame Boucher.
You are a very attractive young person. But somehow, you don't seem to impress me as being consumed with a great passion.
Perhaps I'm not the demonstrative type.
Or perhaps you are not looking forward to your marriage with a starry-eyed eagerness.
Madame.
Oh, no, 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 no. If you're going to have Coy, I'll forget all about it.
I'm sorry, and I do appreciate what you're saying.
You see, Helene, when you marry into the army, you marry into a very narrow set. You meet the same people every day, and you can't run away from anything.
That's just the trouble. I don't want to run away.
Paul Dumont?
Yes. Oh, madame, what am I going to do? to meet Lieutenant Dumont. There was no one in the front, so I came back here looking for you.
I see. Dates?
No, thanks.
Nice Arabian dates.
No, no, I don't.
Good dates.
All right, what are we doing here? Please, no dates. Hassan.
This way, Lieutenant.
I don't care what you say. I ain't never gonna believe nothing like that.
I didn't ask you to believe it. I was telling you what I heard.
Yeah, yeah. What's all this argument going on around here? Meatball here says the colonel's cook said the madam said the lieutenant was going to be transferred.
What lieutenant? Gonna be transferred and where?
Lieutenant Paul, transferred out of here.
Oh, you's crazy. Don't you know if the lieutenant was going to do something like that? Don't you know he would tell me?
Well, of course he would. Or would he?
Lieutenant Dumont. Lieutenant! Lieutenant Dumont! Lieutenant!
And that is the situation. I'm sorry if I've been abrupt in the telling. But something had to be done, Jean.
I think nothing of it, madame. I appreciate your telling me. But I can assure you that everything will be straightened out just as soon as I see either Helene or Paul.
I knew you would understand.
I do understand.
Thank you.
Good night. What are you doing here?
Waiting for the lieutenant, sir.
Where's he gone?
I don't know, sir.
How long since you've seen him?
4 or 5 hours ago, not since I brought him a note from Miss Helene.
What note?
The note over there, sir.
Who is Hassan?
He's a new fortune teller down to the native quarters, sir.
Get a car.
Is the captain going to the native quarters?
Yes, but hurry.
Best I better get Bobo and Meatball and all that.
I don't care who you get, but hurry.
Yes, sir.
Hold it. Has Lieutenant Dumont been here with a young lady? Come on, speak up. Are they here?
No.
I know him. He was with Abadula at Port Egbar.
Sergeant, search the place.
Meatball, in there. Come with me, Bobo.
Are they here? Are they?
No, I don't know them.
You'd better start remembering.
Captain, that back room is full of guns.
Guns?
Yes, sir. Automatics.
Any sign of Lieutenant Dumont?
No, sir.
Captain, Captain. Look at that.
Well, that's from the pocket of a Legion officer's uniform. I'm going to step outside for exactly 2 minutes. And when I return, I expect you to tell me what has happened to Mademoiselle Laroche and Lieutenant Dumont. Do you understand, Sergeant?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Y'all heard what the captain said. You ready?
Ready.
Now. Who do you think you're playing with, a bunch of children? I don't guess you've seen one of these before, but in Harlem, we calls them a persuader, and it is most effective. Now, brother, start talking. Where is the lieutenant?
Hassan took him to Abdullah at the Oasis.
Well, now, that's better. At ease. Captain! Captain! They're at the Oasis.
Good work, Sergeant. You have 30 seconds to spare. I'll leave one man here on guard, and I'll notify the colonel to confiscate these guns.
Yes, sir. Meatball, Bobo, come with me. Egghead, you stay here. Come on, y'all.
More coffee, Lieutenant?
No, thanks.
Come, come. You have hardly eaten a thing. What is it the Americans say? The condemned ate a hearty breakfast.
Then we are condemned?
You are. Just as my brother was condemned from the moment he fell into your hands. I shall try to make your execution as near like his as possible. The conventional sunrise, an often used wall, the drums, and all the rest. Some datesman was it?
No, thank you.
You seem to forget that I represented...
You see, Lieutenant, it would have been so simple for you to admit you were mistaken. Colonel Fouché was more than willing to let Ben Ali go.
Abdullah, let's not fool ourselves that this is all on account of your brother. He led that attack at Wadi Bindu. You know that, or you're not as smart a man as I give you credit for. Maybe you believed his story at the time of the investigation. But since then, you've been able to check up and you know the truth.
Perhaps. But nevertheless, it was you and Capitaine Brideau who sent my brother to his death. I cannot forgive that.
I don't see what you'll accomplish beyond whatever personal satisfaction you may get. By morning, the entire Legion will be out hunting for us.
By morning, the entire Legion will have so much more on its mind that you two will have become quite unimportant. The guns Mademoiselle saw are to be distributed tonight to the native population of Fort Harun. When the signal is given, in a few hours, they will rise to the attack. Oh, yes. Pardon me, Mademoiselle, Lieutenant. I have to give my men their final instructions. Come, Hassan.
Just a few minutes now, sir. I'll cut off the motors. Winds from the east, that ought to put you down about right. Be careful, Captain. That's pretty rough country down there.
Thanks. I'll explain the situation to Sergeant Williams and the men.
Now, the routine is the same as though Lieutenant Dumont were here. Any questions?
No, sir.
Very well.
Remember, boys, this ain't no practice. These is the men that kill Satchel. So follow me by numbers.
All right, Sergeant?
Yes, sir.
All right. Follow me.
Is the captain all right?
Yes, I'm all right. Sergeant, you're in charge until I return.
Where's the captain going?
I'm going to make sure that Lieutenant Dumont is here. If I need you, I'll fire a shot. If not, you remain here until I return. I repeat.
We stay right here until the captain returns or hear a shot. If the latter, we'll charge in and start the blasting.
Correct. I'm sorry to have left you alone so long. But I suppose you had many things to discuss.
Yes.
We were discussing you, wondering if you're insane. We can understand your personal desire for revenge, but surely you don't think you can defeat the government by using against it the things it taught you.
I surely do. Your government taught me many things, but I learned many more. Among them, the fact that France soon would be struggling for its very existence on the continent. What better time to strike out here?
Come here. Come now. You boys hunch down and keep your ears peeled for a shot. If Lieutenant Paul's in there, we ain't coming out without him.
How many is we up against?
Well, I figured that we'd get about 10 apiece.
Suppose there's twice that many.
You don't expect to live forever, do you?
Very bad cough, my friend. Now walk. This way, please. Wait, please. Effendi Abdullah, Captain Bridau to see you.
Jean.
Such touching solicitude. Where did you find him, Hassan?
He was crawling into camp.
Good. You have made my day complete. The Capitaine, his fiancée, and the dashing lieutenant. Leave us, Hassan. And now, mon capitaine, how did you get here?
By automobile.
Searching for the friend who plans to knife you in the back?
No, no, Joe.
It isn't true. It is true, isn't it, mon capitaine? They protest too quickly.
I found a note arranging their meeting at the sand diviners. The Nubian told me where they'd gone. So, like a fool, I drove here. But I should have waited. The trip was too much for me.
And that story is too much for me. You are a fool. You are a fool because even now you're trying to help them. I heard a plane a few minutes ago. Quickly, who came with you?
No one.
Would you die for them? Ahmed! Hassan, alert!
Yes, Effendi!
Patrol the Oasis.
But I tell you, there is no one. I came here to kill him. Give me your gun. Give me your gun!
Paul, he's mad!
Here we go, men!
John, I want to try to explain about
you and Helene. You don't have to. I understand. Take care.
For the lieutenant, sir.
What's on the other hand?
Just a picture of the detachment. We thought maybe the lieutenant would like to have one.
The parachute detachment?
Yes, sir.
Say so. Well,
Why don't we see your signature here? Where are the other boys' autographs?
Oh, they all got it signed.
Where?
You see the mixers right there?
Yeah?
That's it.
Oh. Don't you remember me?
Why, yes, Paul, but I didn't think you wanted to be recognized.
Oh, of course. Then do you remember
Mademoiselle Laroche?
No, not Mademoiselle Laroche. Madame Dumont. We were married this morning.
Well, congratulations. Now, this time, you will sit at my table.
It's a pleasure.